Yo, what's up guys? Welcome to another video on my channel. And in this video I will give you advice to start your e-com store. So if you're planning to start an e-com store, be sure to check the whole video because this will be really good advice, and advice will really help you save a lot of time, get you a lot of results, and get you a lot of sales in the beginning. So let's dive right into the video, guys. Yo, before we go, wait a couple of seconds. Before we go, be sure to check the links in the description, because if I mention a software or a tool, it's probably in there. And make sure to subscribe to my channel and set your post notifications on. So let's dive right into the video, guys. Yo, what's up guys, welcome to my video. And as in the intro, I will be talking about some advice to start your e-com store. So if you are starting your e-com store or you have been starting your e-com store lately, it's really important to watch this video, because I'll give you some advice that we have been struggling with when we are launching our own e-com store. So it's really important to watch a complete video to make sure you can implement each advice I'm giving you, because it will save you a lot of time and a lot of money. Because if you're doing something wrong in your e-com, you'll lose a lot of money. So learn before you want to earn is the first point that we want to talk about, because people are starting e-com store after watching like three YouTube videos, because they think, oh, it's really simple, and everyone makes e-com seem so simple. But e-com is not that simple, because you have a lot of competition. It's really hard to find a winning product, and there are tons and tons of products that you can test. There are a lot of audiences that you can test, so it's really hard. Like, the gurus make it seem really simple to make like 1 million in a month, but it's not simple. So people try to start e-com after watching 3 videos on YouTube. This is just not how it works, because if you're watching videos on YouTube, you'll definitely learn a lot. But it's really important to get a course. Like, we have been doing a lot of e-com course, I think 5 or 6 really high-end course. So we have been spending more than 10k on e-com alone when it comes to learning. So that is really important to learn before you want to earn at e-com, because e-com is a really hard business model. I think we are also, of course, running our SMA, and I think that my SMA is really more simple than an e-com store, because it's with other people, you know who you are talking to, you know exactly what you need to learn, and that's really cool. But with e-com, you have to learn a lot of things at once. So this is a really important point that you have to learn before you want to earn with e-com. So then you have the next point, that you need a clear strategy. So have a clear strategy about the ads that you're going to use. If you're doing print on demand or dropshipping in the beginning, and I would definitely suggest print on demand, because dropshipping, I really don't like that business model. It's not really cool, because you are just shipping stuff from China to people, and they have to wait for like 3 or 4 weeks for that product. So I don't really think that's like a benefit for the people who are buying our stuff. But when you are doing print on demand, it's like, it's customs, cool prints, cool t-shirt, and it delivers really fast, and it's also pretty cheap. So I think print on demand is way better than dropshipping, but you can do both, of course. So it's really important that you have clear strategies, like the ads that you have to use, and this is something that you will learn in a course. If you are doing print on demand, dropshipping or something else, and how you are going to make your brand. So to build your brand, because it's really important that you have a clear brand on your website, so your webshop, because if people are going to your Shopify probably, and they don't really understand like what you are doing, you have a really big ass problem, because people have to understand the branding. Anything has to be congruent and stuff like that. So that's really important. And also, please don't waste time, because there are a lot of people who are just wasting time on their store. Like, they are trying to make everything perfect before they launch, but that's such a waste of time. So don't make everything perfect before you start. Because maybe you are thinking like, I'm not wasting money and stuff like that, and it's true, but you are wasting time, and it's much more valuable. So please don't waste time, just start your store and you have like 5 products on it, whatever. You don't need like 200 products in your store to test it, because maybe your store doesn't work. Maybe you are thinking like, oh, I have really cool products, but nobody gives a shit about products. So you don't need a huge store to start. So that's really important, because having a huge store is cool. It will probably work better takes so much time, and maybe your store doesn't work, and you have been wasting maybe 2 weeks for nothing. So please don't waste time. Don't put too much time, like your description, they have to be good but not perfect. It's a sales letter, so you're just a sales copy. That's really important. So your description is something that you should put work in, but not like 2 days per description, because that's a waste of time and stuff like that. So so yeah, please don't waste time when it comes to e-com, because especially when you are launching products, if you are launching a product, chances are really high that other people are also launching that product, so you have to be really, really fast. So if you're launching a product, you have to work fast for the competition. So that's really important, because maybe you're thinking like, oh, I have the best idea in the world, but let's be clear, guys, a lot of people have that idea and a lot of people will copy it. So you have to be really fast, especially when you find a winner, because then people will copy your product, maybe do it better at more marketing, they will have more capital, and you will have a really big problem because you don't have the knowledge and whatever. So here's where learning comes in play again. It's really important to keep learning when you're doing e-com, not like doing courses 8 hours a day, but you should definitely learn for like 1 or 2 hours a day. And that's exactly what we are doing for SMA and our e-com. Like, before you're going to sleep, you always learn 2 hours. So we check funnels, we check live streams and stuff like that, because we really like to learn and we get more money by it. So then you have another point, is don't get emotionally attached to products. What do I mean with this? Maybe you are having a product, so you are having a winner, and let's say it's really a huge winner, you are making tons and tons of money, but you are seeing like sales are getting less, you have to pay more for conversions, so the product is like dying. So then it's really important to make decision to stop selling the product, because if you keep selling it, you will lose a lot of money, you won't make profit anymore, and you won't have a product. So it's really important that, like, when you are saying, okay, I'm losing a product, that you start finding new products. So it's really important that you don't get attached to a product. Like, it's not, your product will not go forever. Even if you are building a brand, chances are really low that your product will stay forever. So your product will probably not stay forever. So it's really important that you don't get attached to products, you just check the numbers, and that's the next point, of course. Know your numbers, so know exactly how much the product costs, shipping, anything. You have to know all the numbers, because without numbers your e-com will fail, because e-com is just checking your numbers and trying to do better. So and trying to improve these numbers. So that is really important. No, but chances are really low that you are not even keeping track of your product. So you really need a spreadsheet or whatever, or a Word document. You really need something to check how much money you are making, how much you have to pay to taxes and stuff like that. But because it's also really important. So then you have the last point, as a paid team. I think that a paid team is really the way to go, because if you're using one of the standard teams in Shopify, your store will look like any other store, because like 90% of the people are using a free team, and because of that it makes it really hard for you to stand out. So almost 90% people use a free team, so it's really difficult stand out. So if you're using a paid team, you'll definitely stand out, because you will seem like a brand, like a store that has been going on really long, and that's really good when it comes to conversions. And also, yeah, a paid team is way better, because you have more options, you can do more, you can do a lot more. And because of that, I think a paid team is the way to go. And I also have another video on my channel where I do like a breakdown between paid and free team, which is really cool to see. But yeah, let's be clear, guys, a paid team is the way to go. You can start with a free team, but I would not suggest that. It's better to spend like $100 on a really good team and get much more results in the beginning. So this was my little advice starting your e-com store. It's really important to learn before you want to earn. You have a clear strategy. You don't waste time, otherwise you will lose money too. And you don't get emotionally attached to your product, and you know your numbers.
And of course, the last one is a paid team, because I think that's like one of the most important things. Because if people are coming to your store and you seem like a dropshipper, they will go away. But if they come to your store and you have exactly the same products, but you seem like a real brand, they'll probably buy from you and not from the dropshipper. So that is really important. And yeah, that was my little advice, guys. If you have some questions, drop them below in the comments. I will answer them. And I will see you tomorrow in another video, guys.